Children's good morning. This is Shivakumar, PGT Physics, TSMS Madhur from Siddipet district. Today we are going to discuss light lesson. In the topic is refraction through a prism. Prism is a transparent material. It is made up of glass. It is bounded with two triangles and three rectangles. Now we are going to derive the derivation formula for refractive index of a prism. Observe the ray diagram in figure. From triangle PMN, exterior angle is equal to sum of two interior angles. From this statement, D is equal to I1 plus I2 minus of R1 plus R2. Equation 1. From triangle PMN, we have the total angle of triangle is equal to 180 degrees. Here, A plus 90 minus R1 plus 90 minus R2 equal to 180. By simplification, we get R1 plus R2 is equal to A. Equation 2. From equation 1 and 2, we have D is equal to I1 plus I2 minus A. From that, A plus D is equal to I1 plus I2. Equation 3. These equation can gives relation among the four terms, that is angle of deviation, angle of prism, angle of incidence and angle of emergence. From equation 3 can gives relation among the angle of deviation, angle of prism and angle of incidence and angle of emergence. Already we know Snell's law. That general formula of this Snell's law, N1 sin I is equal to N2 sin R. You can apply Snell's law at first phase of the prism and second phase of the prism. Here, first we are applying the Snell's law at first phase of the prism at M point. Here, light ray is coming from rarer medium to denser medium. That is nothing but air medium into glass medium. Let us take values. N1 is equal to 1, I is equal to I1, N2 is equal to N, R is equal to R1. These values can substitute in Snell's law formula. Then sin I1 is equal to N into sin R1. Equation 4. Similarly, you can apply Snell's law at second phase of the prism at N point. Here, light ray is coming from denser medium to rarer medium, that is nothing but glass medium to air medium. Here you can take the values. N1 is equal to N, I is equal to R2, N2 is equal to 1, R is equal to I2. These values you can substitute in Snell's law formula, then N sin R2 is equal to sin I2. Equation 5. Already we know the angle of minimum deviation condition, the angle of incidence is equal to angle of emergence at the same time. Similarly, the angle of refraction at first phase equal to angle of refraction at second phase. That means I1 is equal to I2 and R1 equal to R2. These values you can substitute in equation 3 and equation 2. You will get I1 and R1 values. Now you can substitute I1 equal to I2 in equation 3. A plus D is equal to 2 I1. I1 is equal to A plus D by 2. When I1 equal to I2, similarly R1 equal to R2, that you can substitute in equation 2, 2R1 is equal to A, R1 is equal to A by 2. Now we got two values, that is I1 and R1. These two values you can substitute in equation 4. We get sin A plus D by 2 is equal to N into sin A by 2. Therefore, N is equal to sin A plus D by 2 by sin A by 2. this is the formula for refractive index of the prism. Here d, where d is the angle of minimum deviation, a is the angle of prism, and n is the refractive index of the prism. Finally, we got the derivation formula for refractive index, that is n is equal to sin a plus d by 2 by sin a by 2.